I had been in bed for a couple of days with this leg pain that was just excruciating. And I couldn't really bend my knee. I couldn't really get into a comfortable position. It was just completely debilitating every time I bent my knee. I knew I needed to go to the hospital. I went into the emergency department and they took me back right away. Once they checked my vitals, I think they kind of knew that something was not right.
Marnie presented through the emergency room with an acute pulmonary embolus, or a blood clot that made its way from the lower extremity to the vessel supplying the lungs.
Dr. Diane later explained to me that there were clots in basically every major pulmonary artery. Looking at what he showed me, I'm surprised that I was still breathing. The scary part is that I could feel the clot in my leg, you know, enough to the point where I knew something was wrong. But you really don't feel that in your lungs. And I didn't, when the doctor at the emergency room initially said to me, "Are you having any trouble breathing?" I'm sitting there and I was like, "Nope, I feel fine right now."
Right, and in hindsight, it really wasn't a little short of breath. It was a lot more.
And they explained to me that I did have the right side of my heart was enlarged because it was working too hard to get the blood from my lungs.
We assessed her very quickly and deemed her a candidate for pulmonary artery thrombectomy.
You know, I've heard of a blood clot. I had no idea that this procedure was ever a thing, that you could have these things removed, because I'd never heard anything like that.
There are various ways to remove blood clot from the arteries or veins throughout the body. Mechanical thrombectomy involves a type of clot maceration, which breaks up the clot and removing it in pieces, or it can actually involve aspirating the clot, meaning that we use a vacuum to suck it out.
It was a really simple procedure for me. I slept through most of it, and you know, you don't feel anything and take a nice little nap.
The thrombectomy was a success, with copious amounts of blood clot removed from the vessel supplying her lungs.
5 or 6 years ago, which is not that long ago, if we were to speak, you may have not had as good a result because we didn't have the tools necessary to treat you.
Even during the procedure, Marnie's respiratory status improved, as did the strain on her heart.
So that was one procedure, and then I met with the doctor after that, and he explained to me that that was the procedure that had to be done to save my life, and that we would meet again the following week, outpatient, and take care of the DVT in my leg. He removed a very large clot from my leg. He explained to me that it was from about my lower calf up to my pelvic bone, which explains why I was in so much pain and couldn't move my leg.
Typically, after the thrombectomies in the lower extremities, we recommend increases of physical exercise, compression stockings of a medical grade, and blood thinners.
So even if there's teeny tiny specks of blood clots left over, I didn't see any, frankly, the blood thinner will take care of the rest.
Marnie's case shows the importance of seeking medical care early and how a thrombectomy can potentially save a life.
So I'm very happy that things turned out the way they did for you, and you can enjoy the rest of your life again.
When I got to the hospital Saturday night, I really thought I could possibly die. I really thought, how do I tell my family that I'm laying here with this clot that I have no idea what will happen?
Yeah. Does that look good to you?
Yeah.
What else should we do?
And then to walk out of the hospital with my lungs clear and no risk to my life. It was just a miracle that this procedure is there to save lives. My leg is 100%. My lungs are 100%. I'm back. I have no restrictions. I'm off my blood thinners. I've been totally cleared. And every day I go to work as a first grade teacher teaching special education to another group of feisty, opinionated little kids.
She's really very passionate about teaching. She cares deeply about her students and her family.
She swallowed the ghost to catch the cat. She swallowed the cat to chase the owl. She swallowed the owl to shush the bat. I don't know why she swallowed a bat.
Imagine that.
Imagine that.
That's it. I'm back living the life that I was living before, except now I know I'm lucky.